Hey, welcome back to the channel. It's awesome that you're tuning in. So in today's package from China, we are going to talk about, once again, the Game Stick. I already did a full review about it, but I want to do more dedication to the PlayStation part of the stick. And is this interesting to buy the stick for? Because basically what you're going to get, and then the quick wrap up, you're going to get and take the stick in your HDMI, and you can play some awesome old school games. But the question is, how good are the PlayStation 1 game running? Because sometimes this can be a little bit of problematic. You can always get yourself a PlayStation Mini Classic, because I love my PlayStation Mini Classic. Yeah, I know, and it's got a lot of shitty problems, but at the end, there are a lot of great things you can do with it. But just, we're going to focus on the stick itself, and we're going to have some fun. Inside the box, we are going to find two controllers and, of course, the game stick itself. It says 4K, but what I understand of it is just 1080p. You can use it on a 4K television. It's pretty convenient, very easy, plug and play with an HDMI. Keep in mind that you're going to need an external power supply, 5V, or you can just use a micro USB to USB cable and plug it into your television if you're having free USB connection. The game stick comes with an extender, and you're going to need to extend the cable HDMI simply because you can't use it with a normal connection. I did try it with a monitor, I did try it with my television, because there is always something in the way, because the stick is just way bigger than a regular HDMI connection, and that is a problem. So we're going to need this HDMI extender. With the HDMI stick, we're going to get a SanDisk 64GB built-in. It's the maximum size, so there is no way for adding a 128GB. But I really like the controller itself. Normally we're also going to get this UCOM USB or rip-off PlayStation 2 controller that are pretty damn horrible, but this is not bad at all. It feels quite good. The analog stick feels very nice, and I played some time with it, and I can tell you the D-pad is also very responsive. It works up to 2 AAA batteries, so there is no way to use a rechargeable battery and, let's say, recharge it on the go. The game list itself, or the menu, looks very similar to a Pandora box, but if you want to see more, check the full review. We're going to focus on PlayStation and nothing else. As you can see, it got quite some variation if it comes to different games, but we're going to focus on the PlayStation 1. Just want to see how good are the games running, two-dimensional or three-dimensional. What I do like about it, that with the PlayStation, we can use the original memory card or the virtual memory card, and we can also use the quick load and quick save if you want to do this in a game.
Beep!
So in the main review, I tested out a couple of games and they were not running perfectly. But when you're testing out more and more games, you can see some of them are just running fine. So it depends a little bit what kind of game you're playing. And keep in mind that if you're looking at the specifications of the product, it's not a very powerful Android device. So it's running only on 256 MB of RAM. It has an A7 Cortex dual core inside. And the backend they are running are just a Linux version in combination with RetroArch. But in conclusion, it's not perfect, not at all. There are some minor glitches or some slowdowns. But I just wanted to show you in this video what are the general performance of this device. So yeah, let me know in the comments what do you think of this. Consider subscribing. Give this video a like if you like it and find it helpful. And I will see you in the next video.